I extend a very warm welcome to Shri Kumar Puneet, IAS Special Secretary, IT and Managing Director, UPDESCO, Government of Uttar Pradesh, and Aman Thareja, Director, Commercial Sales, VMware, for a fireside chat to begin our summit.
Thank you, Priya, for this opening address and bringing us all on the same page. It is so true on all the data points which you have highlighted, and certainly I think information technology and digitization is playing a very, very critical role in terms of how organizations from different verticals, different services, different industries are today helping meet the organization requirements, or in terms of government, how we are enabling the citizen services. So I think we are very thankful to Sri Kumar Puneet sir for his time today. Namaskar sir. Sir, aap do shabd bolna chahenge, uske baad main kuch ek do questions maine prepare kiye hain. Maybe with that we can engage the audience and understand your journey also. So before I begin with my first question, over to you sir.
Yeah, Aman, thank you so much. Thank you everyone for being here. When Satya Nadella said some time ago that within 2 years of our existence, we have done a digital transformation worth 2 months. So that has been a very, very tremendous transformation in government as well. The particle visibility is there in the government sector as well. Yes, our motive has been to be a $1 trillion economy by 2025. And its impact is going to be on the sector, particularly in the IT sector, in a very big way. Be it health, be it economy, be it any part, education, manufacturing, wherever you say you can have it. Just recently, we have seen the semiconductor issue that has also been taken by the cabinet to be done in India. So that is a very big decision, and it's going to have a very big impact on the IT manufacturing in India. Well, as we move on, the technology in terms of say perspective in Uttar Pradesh, I would like to highlight that. Before your program, I would just like to mention that Uttar Pradesh is trying to get into the digital enablement or e-governance enablement of students. And on 25th of December, we are going to have a very big program over here where we're going to enable the e-governance or e-learning ability of students so that they can get into this process of learning by distributing smartphone and tablets, and not just by distributing. We are going to distribute each and every student of academic year 2021-22 who is enrolled in any of the courses in Uttar Pradesh, be it Central University, be it State University, be it private, be it public, anyone, any nationality, any state studying in Uttar Pradesh is going to have it. So that is the initiative that is being taken up, and it is not just level to that. That through that process, we are going to enable students by giving them e-digital learning programs as well. And this is going to continue for another 2 years and maybe ongoing program as well if it succeeds. So that is the idea that we are trying to have, how we leverage technology in terms of the students in the present scenario, which is definitely going to be a very big thing for us. If we talk about the government to citizen centric services, the huge data that has been handled at different levels, it has been really, really, really wonderful. If it is the direct benefit transfer of the kisans, or for students, or for pensions, or for anything, ultimately at back end, it is the data that has been to be taken care of and handled very well. And in this process of entire well-being, we come into a concept where we need certain center to keep the data. So we come into the orchestration phenomena of data centers. Now, this data center can be the typical computes that we have, all the computer system and everything and infrastructure, we keep it. And to generate the next level, we now need a hybrid system of entire process that we need to develop into it. So ultimately, the concept, the mood, the analysis is how smooth the delivery of services can be to the citizen, how smooth the transformation of government services can be so that citizen may feel friendly, feel easy and accessible to the government. So that is the idea on which we are all working, and in Uttar Pradesh in particularly, we are really keen on it. Thank you.
Great, sir. Great. Thank you, sir, for opening this today and sharing your experiences in terms of how Uttar Pradesh government is delivering services, not only to citizens, but it really touches me how you are enabling the students and their careers and their learning with help of digital platforms. And I think that is an amazing use of what you're trying to do. And I'm sure that other states and other organizations will also have their learnings. So, sir, this brings me to another question on this one. So, whilst we are trying to roll out this vast array of services to different segments of population as well as industries, I think data center will become more and more critical in terms of delivering these services. So, my question is that how critical is data center modernization? And what are your thoughts around it, sir?
Well, continuous education is a very strategic concept. So continuous education is both for us and for the entire organization as well. Now the evolution of technology, which is creating growth for the companies, new technologies are coming in. So we don't want to be falling apart or just lagging behind. So we want to keep pace with the emerging technologies, the business risks there are involved, of course, there are the slowdowns in operations, negative impacting ultimately in the bottom line, because ultimately the citizen has to get the services. So DC modernization, the data center modernization, is the key to stay ahead in this competition. In this process, we are updating, we are modernizing existing legacy applications, platform infrastructures, architectures, and so many features combined into it. The Internet of Things, the blockchain, every technology that is there in the air, which is coming around. And it is the technology that is going to be the technology of the future. So ultimately, data center modernization has also to be a part of it. It has to be juxtaposed how well we can achieve it.
Sure, sir. Very rightly put across, sir. I think like we have to leverage the technology. And at VMware, we have so many research engineers who spend time, and we invest a lot of money in terms of modernizing the technology, not only in terms of compute, but storage, but networks also. And now more and more stress is being given how we can make security intrinsic to all we do. And I think together with guidance of our users and customers across the globe, we are able to move further. And as I talk about moving further, sir, that brings me to the third and the last question from my side to you. This is a journey, as you rightly said, sir. So in this journey, where do you see multi-cloud, hybrid cloud, edge cloud computing playing a role? And how do you see organizations like yours can leverage that?
Well, Aman, the most important thing for me as an administrator is end-to-end monitoring. Ultimately, I need to have a console that can clearly give me a picture of what actually is going on and how easily that things can come up to me, so that I can be able to give up my administrative inputs into it and to get it developed better. So unified management is one very important aspect that we have to look into with application modernization. When we talk about all these things, we definitely come to a concept where cloud computing is an on-demand activity now. It has to be delivered on demand, whether IT resources through NET or through pay and use charging. Instead of buying or maintaining so many computers, products and services, we need to have something like cloud computing which can come up with this concept. But when I say that, as an administrator, I would say that hybrid clouding or mixed clouding compute, where storage and services environments make up an on-premise certain infrastructure, certain cloud services there on the online on-site, with orchestrations among various platforms. VMware is very important tool to that. See, maybe Azure, maybe Amazon, whatever the services may be. But there has to be a certain level of, both things going on together, where we have certain critical data, which we need to have physically to be very assured of that, yes, my physical data is very much there with me, in front of me. Though it is there in front of me or it is there in any other place, it hardly matters. But then that concept of having a hybrid computing, hybrid clouding is definitely going to be the key thing that should come in days to come. And in terms of Uttar Pradesh, again, I would say that we are, in terms of upgrading our data center, we are going to expand our data center. So we are trying to get it up to tier 3 as much as we can, and then our existing system will also be upgraded in months to come. So we are trying to develop on hybrid cloud system as well.
Sure. Great, Vineet sir. Thank you for sharing your thoughts. And I mean, in a very brief time, you have covered so many different aspects of government, of digitization, and of the people who get impacted with that, with a very, very strong vision of continuing to grow this. So thank you so much, Vineet sir.